My name is Paulino Damiano. I'm the founder of Trees for Kenya. Trees for Kenya has been working here in Kenya for the last almost 9 years, undertaking various activities, reforestation of some of the degraded forest land like Mount Kenya Forest, working with the community, supporting agroforestry, and also greening schools. As I was growing up, I was seeing people cutting down trees, and then we came together as youth, so that, you know, most youth, when they are idle, they engage in crimes. So I organized the youth, and we started raising the seedlings to restore some of those areas which were degraded, yeah, and also supporting the farmers and the community members who are involved in deforestation to plant trees on their farm. Initially, we could only work in a small area, but now as an NGO, we are able to work in other areas, support other farmers, support those initiatives, so that each and every person can be able to be involved in conservation. Right now, we are in Embu, in one of our tree nurseries. We are producing the seedlings for those activities. So we start from here, whereby we mix the soil with the manure, and from there now we put them in the pots. After that, we germinate the seedlings, and then we pick them out, and then we put them in the potting bags, and then we start watering them for a duration of between 3 to 6 months. From there now, the seedlings, they are ready for transplanting.
I'm Daniel Amanaka. I'm a forest ranger manning the Mount Kenya Forest. I wake up early in the morning, head straight into the forest, do my patrols and make sure that everything is okay, no poachers, no trees destroyed. I make sure that I protect the trees and help the nature go well. Trees for Kenya, we do help him a lot in making sure that the trees are surviving in a good way. We help in information and also the follow-up of the trees growing up well.
When we work with the schools, we are nurturing the children, instilling the knowledge of conservation through tree planting, and also we assign each and every tree to each and every pupil so that they can be able to manage them. The reason why we also plant trees in school is to create a shade for them, that is during lunchtime. We want them, when they grow up and they leave the school, they're able to continue with this humble initiative of environmental conservation, so that they can be able to continue to support in the fighting of climate change.
So you see now the forest is now coming up.
2 years old.
Yeah, this one is like 2 years old. Yeah, and you can see it is growing well. Yes, it will be some really very smooth. That can be able to clean some water. Yeah.
I'm Roel, I'm the founder of MOYU. We plant a tree for every product sold, and today we are at the tree planting project of Trees for Kenya. I think we're really making a big impact here. As Paulina explained, like a big area of this has been used for farming. Now the area is protected, but the trees won't come back here by itself. So by planting these trees in a, let's say in 10, 20 years, you will see that this is also such a dense forest that we walked through earlier today. Currently, we're also standing like on the place where trees have been planted. I also learned a lot of, I think, new things about the tree planting project. For instance, all the women that we saw working in the tree nursery, that on a good day, about 100 women are on a daily basis earning an extra income by that. I was really surprised by all the extra benefits that I did not know of what this project has, like the schools and the agroforestry, but also the effect on the water cycle in this area, that almost all the water throughout this whole region is coming from this area, and that by planting trees that this water is being, let's say, saved so that the people have like good water to drink. For me, it's an extreme motivator. You sort of start with this idea of you want to plant trees and push biodiversity, and then I think over the years you sort of, it becomes a lot of around the project MOYU, the stone paper and the writable paper, and now you actually see sort of the fruits of all the work that you've put in, which motivates me extra to like do even more, because there's so much work that can be done here.
Right now we are inside Mount Kenya Forest to rehabilitate this area in partnership with MOYU to plant this tree which you can see here, and we are hoping through planting these trees and taking care of them, within very few years to come it will be a forest again. We have some more animals now, the elephant, they have started coming back. Yeah, we have some gazelles, they have started coming back. Initially, you couldn't see them. Even we have seen some birds, which initially you couldn't see them, because now the area has started the recovery through this process of rehabilitation, through planting of indigenous trees. We have some more areas which we need to continue rehabilitating so that this area can be turned to its normal, the way it used to look maybe 1950s. Yeah, we need it to be like that within the few years to come.